It's the right choice for most Americans, but for others, staying home isn't safe.
An abuser may take advantage of an already stressful situation to gain more control.
Deborah Vagans is the president of the National Network to End Domestic Violence. She says calls to helplines across the country are surging.
People have suddenly lost income and face new stressors, while the community resources are simultaneously limited.
People are feeling anxiety because of the unknown.
Texas Republican Senator John Cornyn says to relieve some of that stress, the latest coronavirus relief bill included $45 million for emergency housing and shelter of domestic violence victims.
We have made sure that they are not forgotten in this coronavirus response.
The CARES Act also provides $2 million for the National Domestic Violence Hotline, which Vagan says is a lifeline for many victims stuck at home.
But New York Democratic Senator Kirsten Gillibrand says more should be done to meet the increasing need.
We need more shelters in place. We need more food and clothing and housing resources made available. We need them to be working at their absolute height so that we can meet the needs of the increase.
Vagans is asking Congress for more than $300 million in the next emergency relief bill.
This supplemental funding will allow domestic violence programs to quickly house and support vulnerable survivors.
She says for some, this could be a matter of life and death. In Washington, I'm Anna Warnicke.